Religious group Iglesia Ni Cristo backs the re-election bid of Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte. The endorsement was announced by Belmonte herself on social media, where she thanked the leadership of INC. Belmonte is running against 8 other candidates for the city's top post, including Partilist Representative Mike Defensor, who is backed by the Unity Team tandem of Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte.
A disqualification case has been filed against a mayoral candidate in Cotabato City for alleged vote buying. The complainant, incumbent mayor Frances Cynthia Giani Sayadi, who says she has proof against her rival former city councilor Muhammad Ali de la Cruz Matabalaw. Sayadi's camp says Matabalaw's men distribute cash and goods to residents in exchange for their vote. The sitting mayor also claims Matabalaw's men have threatened civilians. Matabalaw and the COMELEC have yet to comment on the matter.
Nearly 70% of all polling precincts in the Philippines have completed the final testing and sealing of vote counting machines for the May 9 elections. Included in that count are the VCMs in the war-torn city of Marawi, which is also one of the areas currently under the control of the country's poll body. More from Jeff Canoy.
Marawi is known as a tarp city, where people proudly show off personal accomplishments in banners all over the city. But with elections nearing, most of the tarpaulins now bear faces of candidates courting voters. Some of the streamers hang on private properties that have yet to be rebuilt and renovated from the violence that took hold of the city in 2017. Until now, the memories of the 5-month-long siege and the battle between security forces and the ISIS-linked Mauti group remain topmost in people's minds. Recovery remains a high-stakes issue in the local campaign, where 5 candidates are vying for the mayoralty post. Government rehabilitation continues in what is called the main affected area. Some projects, like the Grand Mosque, have been completed, but privately owned houses and buildings remain wanting, as owners have yet to begin their own rehabilitation. Thousands remain displaced. Aside from the siege, the pandemic and its effect on the local economy remain a challenge for many in the city, which is why first-time voters like Farina Haji Jaber are hoping that the Maranao youth can affect change on election day.
Mas maganda po yung mga bata kasi ngayon, mas inspired kasi, di ba? Marami kaming na-experience during this year's pandemic, Marawi siege. So, masasabi ko na malaki po yung experience namin sa buhay na-experience na mahirap po.
According to the COMELEC, there are 79,244 active voters in Marawi City, a huge jump from the 63,000 during the 2019 midterm elections. On Thursday, a simultaneous testing and sealing of vote counting machines was conducted as preparations continue for May 9.
Sa tingin ko po malaki yung turnout natin ngayon kasi very active yung atin pong mga botante ngayon to voice out kung sino po yung gusto nila. They are assured naman by our security sectors, by our AFP and PNP na magiging smooth naman po yung flow ng election po. Basta po mag-cooperate lang po yung lahat sa gagawin natin po kalala.
Marawi is one of several areas in Mindanao that are under COMELEC control, giving the poll body a hand in ensuring that elections push through given the peace and order situation. Marawi has a history of violence during elections, with intense rivalry among competing parties and election-related killings. Security forces continue to monitor the situation in 33 polling places in the city.
Kahapon, nag-start na kami mag-ikot in order to assess the security doon sa ground. At malaman natin yung mga pangangailangan pa ng mga tao doon sa ground, especially yung mga teachers. And ina-assure namin ng safety ng mga teachers this national and local election.
The military and COMELEC are hoping that this time around, elections in the city will not be marred by violence, especially since this is a high-stakes poll that could make or break Marawi's road to recovery. Jeff Canoy, ABS-CBN News, Marawi.
The Philippine poll body has identified political parties who will get the first crack at the precinct-level election results on Monday. President Duterte's PDP Laban is the dominant majority party, while Senator Cynthia Villar's Nacionalista Party is the dominant minority party. But the COMELEC has yet to make a decision on the petitions filed by the PDP faction led by Energy Secretary Alfonso Pusi and the faction led by Senator Coco Pimentel. Vice President Lenny Robredo's Liberal Party is among the 10 major political parties who will get first crack at the results at the precincts.
The largest Protestant church in the Philippines endorses the presidential bid of Vice President Lenny Robredo along with her running mate, Senator Kiko Pangilinan. The leadership of the United Church of Christ in the Philippines describes the tandem as the best option for the Filipino people. The Council of Bishops says their choice of Robredo and Pangilinan is guided by their commitment to herald the truth and to take the side of the most oppressed and vulnerable. The UCCP has more than 500,000 members in over 2,800 churches. Robredo and Pangilinan earlier received the endorsement of more than 1,000 members of the Catholic clergy.
Here's our Thursday brief on the campaign trail. Vice President Lenny Robredo toured Mindanao for the last time this campaign season. She visited two cities in Misamis Occidental and ended the day in Agusan del Sur. Robredo has been endorsed by many officials in the Paraga region where Agusan del Sur lies. Her running mate, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, separately wooed voters in Vigan, Ilocos Sur. Robredo heads next to Bicol for a series of rallies on Friday. Former Senator Bongbong Marcos and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte held their second meeting de avance. Rains did not stop supporters from attending the event in Tagum City, Davao del Norte. The tandem will hold their third and final meeting de avance in Parañaque City and Metro Manila on Saturday.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte declares Election Day, May 9, a special non-working holiday. Duterte says this is to allow people to properly exercise their right to vote. Around 65.7 million domestic voters are expected to cast their votes for national and local positions on Monday.
The Philippine Defense Department not seeing major security threats that may disrupt next week's elections. Defense Secretary Delfino Renzana also refutes claims chaos may ensue after the polls. He says government troops are ready to respond should disputes sparked by political rivalries erupt across the country.
Isolated lang.
Mm-hmm.
Yung alam naman ng COMELEC kung saan yung hotspot eh, kasi under COMELEC control saka control ng PNP ano.
Mm-hmm.
So far generally it will be a very peaceful election. Meron lang sigurong alam mo naman sa Pilipinas hindi mawawala yung mga awayan ng mga kandidato. So meron yan but it is very isolated.
Mm-hmm.
At saka konti lang yan. Now after election I don't think magkakaroon tayo ng kaguluhan dahil sabi ko nga kung sino yung ipoproclaim ng COMELEC, ayun ang pa natin, ang i-recognize natin na nanalo. Kung inyong kasundaluhan ay gagawin lahat ng kanyang magagawa para tahimik at maayos yung ating eleksyon ngayong narating na eleksyon sa araw, sa Lunes.
Mm.
The Philippine National Police will have a new officer in charge a day before the country's elections. President Duterte appointed Police Lieutenant General Vicente Danao Jr. to replace retiring PNP Chief Leonardo Carlos. Danao previously served as Chief of the PNP Directorial Staff and Deputy Chief of Operations. He is currently the Commander of the National Security Task Force on National and Local Elections.